remember when the virus first showed up in the St. Louis metropolitan area, we believed that the reproductive factor was around 5, which means somebody that was infected could spread it to around 5 people. We believe that because of all of the shelter-in-place orders from our elected officials and then all of the other things that were put into place, hand-washing, hand hygiene, face masks, all of those other things, that we've really dropped that down as a community down to around 1, which is really important. But we can't let up on that now. So that means we've significantly suppressed the spread of the virus, which is critical to reopening the economy. And we want to make sure that we don't go backwards. We always want to be in front of the curve, which means we need to be practicing all of these things that we have been doing while we go forward. But again, we'll keep an eye on the data to make sure that we are moving in the right direction, even after we open the economy and all of those things have taken place, to make sure that we're doing all those right things. So let me talk a little bit now about our hospital admissions rolling average. So as you can see, we're still having an impact on this data from all of those things we've been putting in place to reduce spread. And again, this chart shows that the trend of our daily hospital admissions since early April, and it continues to go down. So back in early April, we were admitting as many as 60 patients a day that we either were confirmed or suspected of having COVID-19. And that rolling average has continued to fall steadily since early April, with a few upticks here and there. The data reported on this chart are lagged for about 2 days, and so as you can see, on Wednesday we admitted 33 new patients for COVID, and the rolling average is around 38, and so this trend again continues to go downward, and this is really what we want to see and what we'll continue to monitor going forward. And now I'll move to the slide that most people are very familiar with, and this is our hospitalization rolling average. And we remain encouraged by the flattening of our hospitalization numbers. The chart shows that our daily hospital census of COVID positive and suspected COVID patients, as well as the rolling average. And so as you can see, the April number that was rapidly climbing earlier in April, but today's rolling average is around 625, which is good. So it's starting to come down. And our current hospital census fell significantly from yesterday, from 596 to 506, and we hope that will continue and accelerate. The moving average fell as well, from 646 to 625. And so, again, that's encouraging data that we're headed in the right direction, that all of those policy decisions that were made by elected officials and then all of those other instruments that we put into place are really having an impact on spread, which is impacting hospital admissions. So this number has come down really significantly. It helps our hospitals then be prepared for any increase in cases that we might have going forward, keeps us from being overwhelmed, and it helps us then catch up with our PPE supply, with our testing supplies, all of those other things. It just helps us be better prepared in case we do see any increase in number of cases.